Got a gas station. Wanna make no money in debt. Sold the gas station. Got a liquor store. In Mississippi. Mm-hmm. Pay cash. He's out building $4,000 to pay cash for that building. And I'm saying all that to say this. Get your own. When you work for a job, you got no tax benefits. Mm-hmm. In order to be successful, you gotta reduce your taxes. How you do that? You start a business. So you can start a business for $300. Call making moves. And now you get a tax exemption. Write-offs. And see, this is what we don't get into. We're more interested in everything else. It's on TV. With the game. And that's part of my life. We got Thursday night football. I could care less. So I was at the dollar store one day and a lady asked me, you going to watch this on Sunday? You going to watch the game? I said, no. I don't watch anything. I go on and read books, so I'll be reading. She looked at me like, you're not going to watch the game on Sunday? No. But that's what we do.
Yeah.
That's what we do. But I can't watch the game because I went to a game with a man. I can't go watch the game now. Because what I did was we took a Learjet from Dak to New Orleans. Stepped out of the jet, stepped into a limo. Stepped out of a limo, went to the Superdome. Left the Superdome, went up to the Skybox. Left the Skybox, went. I mean, it was like, dude, I cannot go. No. Mm-hmm. After that, went to the Orson House, we had food. You couldn't put on all this. You just, oh, I guess we'll just, I mean, he just, here's a tip. This is a millionaire. He's, you know, part of the partnership I worked at. We had one bonus. And me and the other guys, the bonus was to get to go to the Saints game. And we was here, he said, meet me and Dad. I rented my friend's Learjet. So me and the guys got a van, we drove up that, got on Learjet. I mean, it was just like, this is a millionaire. So people are like, no, after that experience, I want to be a millionaire now. I can't sleep. I can't watch the game on TV. I'm sitting in the sky. All you can eat, all you can drink, the restroom right here. If you're sitting in the stands, you got to wait in line. Go to the, get you something to eat. A hot dog is $12. A soda, $9. And I'm sitting here, I just left a Learjet in a limo. Now you're talking about, oh, watch the game on TV? Are you out of your mind? I can't do that. It's not the same. Because I'm sitting here like, how in the world? You know, but what you have to look at this. You, everything happens for a reason. Nothing is happenstance. I was there for a reason. And that's what we have to understand. A lot of us, because of our perception, opportunities come across, but we can't recognize them, so we miss them. I was in Atlanta one day, a lady came, well actually a guy came up, and I asked him, I said, what's that car sign on your car? And he said, this is known as juice, this I sell it. I said, okay. So he left. Another lady came by, and she had an old Chevy Blazer, her tag said Florida, and it said known. I called Cajun lady, I asked her, I said, what's that? She told me, it's a company, this. I said, I'd like to know about it. The black guy asked, he just left, I come back tomorrow. The lady took me to Starbucks, we sat down and talked, called her Mexican friend, he came. Next thing I know, they millionaires. I didn't know they were millionaires, but I'm just that type of person. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Well, the black guy, he passed by like that.
Yeah, he told me, he said, this is the juice, I sell it. He poured a little water like this, said, yeah man, I'll be with you tomorrow. I'm looking at him like, oh, I don't know more about it right now, but he left. Okay, as soon as he left, this lady pulled up with his red blazer. Her name was Jan Knutson. She's passed away, I just found out. Mm-hmm. But this lady, she said, hey, tell me what no more about it. Let's go to Starbucks. I said, okay, it's right down the street. I went down there, sat down and talked to her. And when I talked to her, she was like, Tim, you're one of the top sellers. I was showing her all my stuff. You know, 1 month, I made like $13,000. I was like, damn, I made 13,000, 1 month, I made $11,000. This. She said, Tim, I need you in my company. I said, I'm writing a book. I had a little folder. It was a folder. It wasn't even a book, it was just legal pad. She said, you writing a book, Tim? She said, I got 5 chapters left. And I'm sitting there, I was talking to her like I'm talking to you now. She was like, Tim, I need you to work for my company. I need you to come work with me. She said, ma'am, I need you to come and meet Tim. Come to Starbucks right now. And he's like, okay, he get there. What are you so excited about? Can't meet Tim. He's writing a book, ma'am. We need to get him in our company. They took me out to lunch every day. They're millionaires. I'm gonna tell you something that's gonna blow your mind. They took me, there was a cafe they put at Atlanta Station, downtown Atlanta. They took me down, I heard about this guy named Robert. They took me down there, and he was in this glass room having a meet with this other guy. And you could look through the glass and see him in there talking.